Les will try to pull rubbish on you on set, like after a scene, if there's a little bit of time, a few seconds after a scene, he'll sort of need you in the ribs, or you know, or try to, you know, spill your drink on you or something. So I just think it's somebody's responsibility to stand up to him, seeing as he's sort of taken it on himself as a practical joker of the show. The only smoothness about him is what's written in the scripts. In real life, he's a blithering idiot, a dork, a klutz. He falls over things. He can't. No, I'm actually going. He's not a bad bloke at all. I just thought I'd have to pay him out. But I'd like to do sports commentary. Australian rules football or cricket. And that's it. That sounds bizarre. No, I mean, there are obviously other shows I'd like to act in, but I mean, I think that'd be great, yeah. It'd provide a good challenge, yeah. I can't dance. And I decided that in life there are some things which you're just not cut out to do, and that sometimes you've got to draw the line and just say, well, that's it, I'm not going to dance. That's just one thing I can't do. I've actually cleared dance floors before. I've said, oh, let's go for a dance, and got out onto the floor, and just people find me offensive. I don't know why. It's just one of those freak of natures, you know. I just can't pull it together to dance. Unfortunate but true. I fall over and knock people over and that sort of thing. Oh no, I'm not a klutz in everyday life like Les Hill is. I mean, you know, I can walk in a straight line.
Hey, guess what we've got for you now? This is a behind the scenes look at Home and Away.
Behave. Listen, I'll do the hair, you do the acting, okay? This is the ugly makeup today. He's getting the ugly job.
Yeah, she has been known to put on a bit of ugly makeup if she gets a bit of cheek.
Alistair, anyway. You, it's impossible.
Okay, this is the wardrobe department. This is where we all come to get changed. This is on my side. Welcome, Shane. Some of the stuff I have to wear, my big jacket. There's a couple of girls that wrote in to me, and they said that they love this shirt. This is the shirt that I wore at Greg and Bobby's wedding, I think. But a couple of people like this shirt. I'm not too keen on it myself. These tartan shorts, I'd probably say that these are the ones that I don't like very much.
Hey, listen.
Well, what has just happened in that scene is Finlay and Blake. Well, Finlay is in love with Blake, and Blake's heart really isn't in it. So my character, Adam, has sort of devised a scam in which Finlay will fall out of love with Blake. And we're just going through the throes of organising that scam. So that's what's happening there. Any love triangles? No, not at all. I usually keep myself quite clean.
Hi, my name's Dieter Brummer, and you're watching Smash Hits Video Magazine.
I got this job through an agency of, you know, the agency which I'm in. Just sent me along for auditions. I finally, you know, I had auditioned for Home and Away for other various roles. And then when this part came up, you know, I was asked to go along for the audition. I received a couple of callbacks, and finally it was out of me and another guy from Melbourne, I think. And I went back for the last callback, and then, you know, I was told sort of a week and a half before I got the job that I was, you know, I had to work the next Monday. My first impressions of the show would have been a lot less glamorous than I thought. You know, I thought TV industry, you know, really glamorous. Everyone's, you know, treated like a star all the time. But really, it's no different to any working environment, you know. I mean, you're there to do your job. A lot of my mates think it's very much the same as, you know, what I would normally be at school, or, you know, just around.
They think my character's very funny. They like him. Yeah, I think if I was a good guy, I don't think I'd be as popular. But you know, when people see me stealing cars and you know, doing being cheeky, you know, they think, oh yeah, that's Dieter. That's normal.
Yes, I do watch a lot of telly. I think I watch a touch too much than I should. I tend to get home and, you know, by the end of the night I've got very square eyes.